Hey guys, welcome to Car Guy 1999 Reviews as well as Quirk Auto Dealers. Today we have the all-new 2021 Nissan Rogue. Completely redesigned for the 2021 model year. The 2021 Rogue really is absolutely phenomenal. I'm going to go ahead and open up the back area. You can see tons of room back here. Is there third row seats? I don't know. I don't think there is, because there would be no way to get back there. For those of you that find this mildly satisfying, there you go. Got storage underneath. I mean, this thing is awesome. Shut it. Got a button right there. Overall design of it, it's a much more G-Wagon kind of look, where I forget to unlock cars. No, it's much more boxy than the previous gen. The previous gen was very, very car-like. This has a much bigger focus on being like an SUV. Super comfortable rear seats, nice panoramic sunroof. This is the Platinum model. Oh, this is probably the easiest SUV to get out of I've ever been in. The rear seat sat up almost like a bench, where I can see forward perfectly. Something, if your kids get car sick, it's a huge bonus. Now, because the bodywork flares in like this, getting out, your leg fits here perfectly, and it's probably one of the easiest SUVs I've ever gotten out of. I do believe this is the 2.5 liter four cylinder. Squishy. Oh, pretty cool. You can see the whole brand new front design. Nissan calls this grille the V grille. Kind of looks more like a U though, but still pretty cool. These vents here are functional for aerodynamics, as well as, I do believe, brake cooling in a roundabout way, because you'll see they'll cut through this bodywork, kind of help eliminate that dead air that sits in your wheel wells and affects your fuel economy. So now you can really see how much of a boxier design it is. The previous Rogue was very, very flowing. This one has a little bit more sharp edges, but it makes it look so good. Total price on this one is $39,410. I'm gonna bring this seat back just to make visibility a little bit better. You do have airbags in between the seats, which is pretty cool. Alright. Blue. I don't know what that color name is. It says blue, black. I don't know. Interior is charcoal. So this is the 2.5, 181 horsepower, 181 pound-feet of torque, the Xtronic CVT. This one's pretty optioned out. I think you could still bring it up a couple levels. But at $39,410 for the amount of luxury you get and the looks of this thing, honestly, it is pretty impressive. I have to figure out what that color actual name is, because it's abbreviated on the sticker. Interior, of course, is redesigned. You know what? I'm gonna look it up. I don't know. Oh, I'm a moron. So it's two-tone, blue metallic, and super black. That's what it is. Makes sense. I mean, these are your colors available. Bunch of boulder gray pearl is a beautiful color. Saw that in person today. Caspian blue is the color as configured. But yeah. All your traffic, Sirius XM, of course, your main home screen, which you can customize. Figure out like what you want each little square to be. It's pretty cool. I like it. I'm a huge fan of it. Go ahead, turn on the AC a little bit. Digital dashboard, starting to become the norm. Nice steering wheel, very, very square bottom, flat bottom design. But it's really, really simplistic, and that's what I like. It makes it easier to learn, and it just makes everything a bit easier. All right, now that I've rambled on for what seems like an eternity, let's go for a drive. I'm gonna be driving in sport mode. It defaults to auto. But what I like about this is it has a good amount of feedback. It does spin forever, but it takes a good amount of force to go between modes, and that is very, very nice. Do have paddles behind the wheel, which I might try out. I'm not 100% sure though, because the CVT doesn't really have gears, so those are more for downhill braking than being a true manual mode. Right now on the main display, I have the four-wheel drive enabled, so you can see where power is being split. However, once you go into either snow or off-road, it's always gonna keep supplying power to the rear wheels, even in coasting. Even as I'm coasting to a stop, it's going to supply power to the rear wheels, so it makes it a full-time all-wheel drive. It will still adjust based on conditions and traction, of course, but you're always going to be powering all four wheels. Bose stereo system sounds absolutely fantastic. Bose is one of my favorites, and they've been partnered with Nissan for quite some time. And yeah, I mean, the Rogue is a huge step in the right direction for Nissan. Really makes it extremely luxurious, extremely techy kind of thing, and it really gets it out of the mindset of being in a rental car fleet. Previous Rogue, you know, it just kind of looked rental car-ish. This does not. This looks like a luxury car. What's nice, you won't be able to notice it on camera. At least I don't think you will. But the gauges have texture to them. So it almost looks like gray denim on the gauges itself. It's not just a color. There's some texture to it. And it really kind of makes it seem more real, like actual gauges. It really kind of spices everything up. I'm a huge fan of it. I don't like looking at just color. You know, I want there to be something there, something to be like, oh, if I could touch it, there would be something there. It's really, really well done. They're very 3D-esque, especially with that inner red ring, with the shadows that they have and everything like that. It seems 3D, not just there. I'm a huge fan of it. It's one of the best multi-mode digital dashboards I've seen. And I've seen a lot of great ones, especially from like Ford, Volkswagen, Audi. Volkswagen and Audi are the same thing, but no, it's very, very well done. Now I'll put it into manual mode and we can talk about the driving dynamics. It's actually very, very good. A lot of kind of sporty feels to it. I've been driving it in sport mode, but it still applies to your snow, off-road mode. Steering, it's light, but does provide a good amount of feedback of what's going on. I can feel when the front wheels start to lose grip. I can feel kind of bumps in the road. Of course, it's not going to be completely commutative like, you know, your 718 GT4 is, but it is there. Handling wise, it's very good. Completely forgot I was in manual mode. It does handle quite well. There's a good amount of mechanical grip from these tires. And yeah, it's really impressive. Another thing with this boxy design is I think what they were going for was the commanding feel. When you drive a G-Wagon, that boxy design really makes you feel commanding. It sits you higher up. My seat is all the way down and I feel really, really high off the ground, almost like a pickup truck. And that's what a lot of people buying SUVs want. They want that higher up feel. They want the excellent visibility and that commanding feel of being in a high riding vehicle. And it really provides that without sacrificing fun to drive emotional feel of it. It's a really, really fun to drive crossover. And I really think they stepped up the game with this redesign. And I'm very, very curious to see if the Rogue Sport comes out with a redesign this year or next year, because I'm very curious to see how they improve that. But I mean, it is absolutely phenomenal. First one seeing one in person was today, and now I'm driving it, and it's very, very cool, very impressive, and very, very fun to drive. Alright you guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Please like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next one.